Hello, kids. Welcome back to your English lesson. How are you doing today? Before we present the teacher's helper of this lesson, I want to share you the podium for the Kahoot challenge that you played during the weekend. Are you ready? Congratulations, you guys. You did excellent. I hope more can join us on our following challenge. Now, are you ready to meet the teacher's helper of the day? Let's look at the picture. Can you guess who he is? Yes, he is Sebastian. Hello, Sebastian. Can you help me with the date? What day is today? Yesterday was Wednesday, so today is? Very good. Today is Thursday. Are you ready to start the class? Let's go. Today we are going to start our lesson by practicing a new tongue twister. This was shared by Alejandro Diaz. Are you ready? Let's look. Why don't you write white with letter Y? I don't know why you write white with the letter Y. Was it easy or hard? It's kind of hard, right? We are going to keep practicing it, all right? Now, let's go to the class activities. We are going to start with the English skills section of your book. Let's watch the following video. Pay attention.
Uncle.
Happy to learn.
What did you see in the video, Sebastian? A fire station. Yes. Have you ever seen or visited one? I have seen a lot of fire stations, but I never have been into one. Would you like to visit a fire station? It sounds interesting, right? Now, let's go to page 48 of your English book. Let me share you my screen, all right? So here we are on page 48, the fire station. We have to listen to the track and then read the statements and check the correct one. Ready?
The fire station. Listening comprehension. Listen to the dialogue between Bobby and his Uncle Ted. Read the statements and mark the correct one.
Uncle Ted, I'm glad Miss Veronica took us to visit the fire station.
Yes, Bobby, me too. I liked to show your classmates the fire trucks.
Thank you for letting my friends put on the fireman's hat, boots, and coats.
You are welcome. Bobby, do you remember what I said?
Yes, you talked about the danger of playing with fire and said, "Never play with matches."
One. Miss Veronica took the class to visit the post office. Miss Veronica took the class to visit the fire station. Two. Uncle Ted showed Bobby's friends the building. Uncle Ted showed Bobby's friends the fire trucks. Three. He let them put on the firemen's hats, boots, and coats. He let them use the hoses. Four. Uncle Ted talked about the danger of playing with fire. Uncle Ted talked about the danger of climbing trees. Five. Uncle Ted said, "Be careful with fire." Uncle Ted said, "Never play with matches."
Was it easy or hard? Remember that you can stop your video anytime so you have more time to answer each section. Now we are going to turn to page 49. Let me share you my screen. Let's look at the pictures. What can you see there, Kika? Do you see a bicycle? What about a fire truck? What color is the fire truck, Sebastian? Green and blue, or white and red? Perfect. What else can you see there, guys? Can you see the firefighter jackets? What color are they, Elisa? Are they red? Or are they yellow? Remember that the firemen wear those jackets to protect themselves from the fire. What else do you see over there, guys? I can see a hat and also a pair of boots. Remember, firefighters wear these items to protect themselves from the fire, all right? Let's look at the partner work section. Take turns telling a partner what you see in these pictures. We already did that. Now read the examples and then make your own using the word bank. I see a clean, shiny hat. So why don't you complete the sentences 2 and 3 with the word bank below? I know you can do it. To know a little bit more about what firefighters do, watch the following video.
Uncle.
Happy to learn.
Now it's time for you to pause the video and take your break. I will see you in a minute, all right? Welcome back, kids. Are you ready for our next activity? Was it easy to understand? What do you think we are going to work with today based on what you watched on that video? Now, let's check if what you said is correct. Please go to page 112 of your English book. I'm going to share you my screen. How can I make a map? Create a map key. Draw the symbols you will use for each thing on your map. So remember that the map key is like our dictionary. With it, I can help myself identify what am I looking at a map. We have the word three. We have the word tree. So what do you have to draw? Yes, a tree. Read at the other words and make sure you create your pictures for each. Now, on the other activity says, create a map with the symbols. Your map should have four trees, one school, one playground, two roads, and one compass rose. Remember that you have to add colors to your map. Don't forget that. Was it easy for you to create the map? Keep practicing. I know you can do it. Now we are going to turn to page 113 to work on the vocabulary section. Are you ready? Here we are going to listen to the words and sentences. Ready?
Vocabulary. Listen to the words and sentences. Then listen and repeat with your best pronunciation. Next to. The teacher is next to the boy. Far. The boy is far from the chalkboard. Near. The girl is near the chalkboard. Between. The boy is between the two girls.
Now we are going to listen to it one more time. Make sure you repeat each word before.
Vocabulary. Listen to the words and repeat with your best pronunciation. Next to. Next to. Far. Far. Near. Near. Between. Between.
Remember that the words from the vocabulary help us identify where a person, animal, thing, or place is located. They are prepositions of place. To keep practicing the prepositions of place, listen what you have to do. Go to your living room. Look at the TV. Where is it located? Use one of the words from the vocabulary on page 113 and create a sentence describing where your TV is. Okay? Make sure you complete the self-assessment section at the bottom of your page to end this activity, all right? Now, pause your video here and take another break. I will see you in a minute. Hi, kids. Welcome back. Now, we are going to work on the Think Tank section of our books. Ready? This is the last activity of the day. Before we start, let me ask you some questions. Maria Fernanda, have you ever given anyone something before? Yes or no? What was it? Guys, I want you to help me answering this question. Go to the blank pages section of Think Tank and draw a picture answering the question, have you ever given anyone something before? What object was it? Now, open your books on page 168. We are going to read, understand, and solve a problem. Are you ready? Let me share you my screen, all right? Let's start with the read section. Annie likes to help others. She gives money to help people and charities. She recently gave money to 2 charities. How much money did Angie give to charities altogether? So we have 1 and 2 charities. The question says, how much money did Annie give to charities altogether? This is our keyword, altogether. Do you think we are going to make an addition or a subtraction? Let's read the understand section. When adding money, you can count bills and coins to help you. If you don't have real money, you can draw pictures of bills or coins. Find out how much money Anne gave to charities altogether. You can always draw a picture to help you solve the problem. So we already know that we have to make an addition, guys. Let's look at the charities. Animal Rescue, she gave $10. And Homeless Shelter, she gave $8. $10 from the first charity, then $8 for the homeless shelter. That's your addition. Now what you have to do is to represent that amount of money with coins or bills and create and solve your addition. Remember to write the answer of that addition on the correct space. I know, okay? Make sure you pause your video here so you have time to answer. Was it easy or hard? Now, to close this activity, please answer the reflect section at the bottom of your page. Now, how can you explain somebody else what borrowing and giving mean? Now, we've reached the end of our lesson. Let's dismiss this class by practicing the tongue twister Diego shared with us one more time. Are you ready?
Why don't you write white with letter Y? I don't know why you write white with the letter Y.
Now you can challenge your mom or dad and see who can make it faster, all right? I will see you tomorrow. Bye.